Hope you guys are doing well. I wanted to share with you this new HEPA filter for the Tesla Model 3 or Tesla Model Y. I know what you're thinking, another HEPA filter for the Tesla that may restrict the airflow or may not truly be a HEPA grade filter. If you have seen any of my previous videos regarding the filters I have used, I always test the air quality with this air monitor I have. The lower the TVOC rating, the better the air. In my previous video, the X-Techner HEPA filters came in at 0.16 TVOC, which was on recirculate mode for 3 minutes. The Breathe Easy cabin filters came in at 0.11, also on recirculate mode for 3 minutes. When this company, Luftt, sent me their HEPA filters for their Model 3 and Model Y, they told me these are truly HEPA-grade filters that will not reduce the airflow. To back up their word, I put my good old handy air quality monitor to use again. Since I was already dismantling the panels to access the filters, I figured why not just clean the coils real quick. Instead of buying 2 cans of Kool-Aid, I decided to try out this Cleaner Pro that contains more foam cleaner in one container. Also, if you look closely, the spray tube is designed to spray multi-directional. This improves the cleaning process, making sure the entire section gets covered with the foam. When spraying this cleaner on the coils, be sure to turn off the fan and also the AC. When I was doing this job, the fumes are quite potent. You may want to wear a mask to protect yourself. One container is more than enough. As you can see, it started running out the side. I let the foam do its job by letting it sit for 20 minutes as the instructions say in the bottle. After that 20 minute time frame, you want to run the fans on high for 2 minutes to make sure the coils are completely dry before inserting the filters. You should see a puddle of liquid cleaner under your Tesla after the foam has receded. Once we know the coils are completely dried out, we are now ready to insert the new Luftt HEPA filters. Be sure to look for the airflow arrows and insert them correctly with the pull tabs facing outward. The white part is now facing the passenger seats, not the front of the car. Once installed and everything is all put together, I waited a day so the car could take time to breathe and fully remove all the cleaning smell, as this can spike the reading on the airflow monitor. The next day I did the same 3-minute test on recirculate mode, just like I do with the rest of the filters. We started off at 0.09, and to my amazement, it dropped quickly to 0.001 and finally a flat 0. During the last minute and a half, the device read 0 to 0.02. I have never seen until now a filter that has had a TVOC rating of 0. I guess the Luftt company wasn't joking. It must really be HEPA filter grade. If you are concerned about airflow, I must say I can't tell a difference whatsoever. If anything, I think the airflow has increased using these new filters. If you are using a pre-inlet filter like this one, or have a coverlet screen, the airflow may reduce slightly. I personally just use the coverlet screen to prevent debris like twigs and leaves from falling down into the vent. If you have that rotten egg smell when you first get into the car and the AC turns on, and you need additional info on how to clean the coils yourself, be sure to check out my first YouTube video under my channel. I have links down below for all of the items I have mentioned in this video. Overall, it looks like we now have a winner for the best internal cabin filters for the Tesla Model 3 and Tesla Model Y. The air smells great even when driving around diesel trucks and even idling at red lights. For the best air quality inside your car, it's recommended from the manufacturer to replace these every year when possible. But because I live down here in the south where the humidity is pretty darn thick, I'm going to replace these every 6 months. Again guys, my name is Evan, and if you found this video helpful, be sure to hit that like button for me and subscribe for more future content. I'll catch you on the next one. Until then, take care.